Today, ransomware attacks are targeting critical infrastructure like oil pipelines, manufacturing systems, hospitals, and rail systems. The consequences of these attacks include millions of dollars, coupled with the price of a total operations shutdown.
In 2020, we saw 9 cyber attacks that shut down industrial operations.
Ransomware groups are using nation-state attack techniques against everyone who has money.
The good news is that industrial sites can put in place simple defenses that reliably defeat even the most sophisticated of ransomware and other targeted attacks. Today's ransomware attacks do not ask for a couple hundred dollars to restore the family photo album. Modern ransomware criminals demand millions of dollars to restore operation to an entire encrypted network. In a disturbing trend, today's ransomware groups are using the tools and techniques that only a few years ago were used exclusively by nation-state intelligence agencies.
In 2020, we saw 9 cyber attacks that shut down industrial operations. Every one of these attacks was targeted ransomware. And in 2021, we saw some of the most high-profile cyber attacks in history on critical infrastructure. And again, the perpetrators were targeted ransomware groups.
Victims of the 2021 Colonial Pipeline and JBS attacks paid millions of dollars in ransom, and each lost days of production. Molson Coors was the target of a ransomware attack that impacted brewery operations, production, and shipments. 2020 saw an alleged nation-state compromise a SolarWinds security update, an update that up to 18,000 customers then downloaded and presumably installed. Less than 6 months later, a ransomware group used a compromised Kaseya cloud service to drop ransomware disguised as a security update to 1,500 victims simultaneously.
Too many of us with critical infrastructure and manufacturing operations, we think, hey, we're not that important. Why would a nation state ever target us? The answer is profits. Ransomware groups are using nation state attack techniques against everyone who has money. If we have money, then we're targets.
Most ransomware incidents that have OT consequences use remote control. The criminals use stolen remote access credentials to log into OT networks directly, or to seed remote control tools into internet-exposed IT networks with email phishing attacks or drive-by downloads. Those attack tools are known in the industry as remote access trojans, or RATs. A RAT gives an attacker remote control of a victim's computer over the internet, much like typical remote desktop tools. The attackers use the RAT to spread through firewalls, find more valuable targets, and eventually encrypt everything valuable that the RAT can touch.
OT shutdowns from ransomware happen for one of 3 reasons. Attackers can deliberately push the RAT into industrial and OT networks, specifically targeting physical operations. This is what the Triton attackers did in 2017. Or number 2, attacks can take down the IT systems that are essential to operations. This was NotPetya. NotPetya crippled Active Directory servers at Maersk. Maersk was the world's largest container shipping company. NotPetya crippled the servers that were needed by the IT systems that printed labels and printed instructions for where each container had to be sent. Or 3, sometimes ransomware makes us shut down physical operations in an abundance of caution. When our IT systems are compromised. What does that mean? It means that we're not confident of the strength of our OT security system, not confident enough to keep physical operations running when IT has been compromised.
The root of the problem is connectivity. Targeted ransomware attacks break through firewalls routinely. Thousands of IT networks were compromised this year by targeted ransomware. Every one of these attacks broke through the corporate to internet firewall.
Today's modern attack environment calls for hardware-enforced protection for industrial and OT networks. Power plants, pipelines, water utilities, rail systems, manufacturing plants, and many others are just too important to be protected by software alone.
Unidirectional security gateways are hardware-enforced, providing physical protection for OT and industrial networks. The gateway hardware provides a physical barrier that prevents remote attacks, malware, ransomware, and any online attack information from entering the protected network. Unidirectional gateways are a combination of hardware and software. The hardware is physically able to send information in only one direction, from the OT or control network into the IT enterprise network. The gateway software makes copies of databases and other servers. Enterprise users and applications connect to these replicas and interact with them normally. The enterprise replicas contain all of the latest OT information that is allowed to be shared outside of the OT network.
There's only so much that firewalls, antivirus systems, intrusion detection systems, and other kinds of software protection, there's only so much they can do for us. All software-based systems have vulnerabilities that can be exploited. They all have configurations that can be misconfigured. They all have permissions that attacks can piggyback on. Secure industrial operations do use security software, don't get me wrong, but they don't use only software. Secure sites add a layer of hardware-based physical protection.
Critical infrastructures all over the world are using Waterfall's hardware-enforced unidirectional gateways for security. For more information about hardware-enforced protection, please visit the Waterfall Security Solutions website. And if you would like a free consultation with a Waterfall expert to look at how unidirectional gateways can help your organization, please visit the Contact Us page on the Waterfall website.